My name is Bjørnar Sæther. I'm with the University of Oslo within Human Geography. I've been listening with great interest to the presentations today. Today, now we're going to look into one case in what is called Scandinavian Mountains. It's on the border between Sweden and Norway. This is a single case study of a, I think we can call it a success region. It's a success case. And also, since so many of you are policymakers, my initial comment is that this success is not that easy to copy for other small places today. However, it's a very important discussion, of course, and that is what you are going to discuss, how other places can experience some sort of success. And then we start with this map provided by Norregio. This map shows the region of Inner Scandinavia, which is a cross-border region. We have Oslo down in the left corner, and a little bit outside the map, we have Stockholm. The region that I am going to talk about is this region here, consisting on Trysil and Engerdal municipalities on the Norwegian side, and Malung-Sälen mainly on the Swedish side. And we have the city, or not the city, the town of Trysil and here, and we have the small place Sälen down here. And when we look at the maps, these small towns, they don't show up, because they only have 1,000 permanent inhabitants, which are registered by the Statistics Sweden and Statistics Norway. But during the winter season, this region has probably more than 200,000 inhabitants. This would have been the biggest cities in this map if the tourists visiting this region during February and March had been calculated by Statistics Norway. And of course, and Statistics Sweden. And of course, this is a huge challenge for this region, but it's also a very good thing because it provides income and jobs for this region, which is so important. And it's the most popular tourist region for winter tourism in Scandinavia. But it has a long history. So I think it's necessary to start with the history to understand this case in more depth, to understand this region in more depth. And we could go back all the way to the 1960s, where forestry was the major business in this region. It still is a big business, but then it was very much dominating in the local economies, and the people were using horses to carry timber out of the woods. But there was a major technological change in forestry starting in the 60s, and the lot of forest workers lost their jobs. They were replaced by machines, new technology. A lot of forest owners lost a lot of value creation, and there was a major population decline of about 40% in the 50 years period starting in the 1960s. And of course, this raised major questions for every household in this region. Should they leave the region? Should they try their luck in Stockholm? Should they try their luck in Oslo? Or should they try to develop jobs, businesses in the region that could provide food on the table for the family? That was the question, food on the table. It was not a question of becoming rich, no. And so it was entrepreneurship based on necessity. And some forest owners established a ski lift in this mountain in the early 60s. And on the Swedish side, there were early on quite huge investments in ski lifts in the 70s. And also the forest owners learned that to their big surprise, urban people were willing to pay quite a lot for land where they could raise a cabin and spend their weekends on holidays. So they started to make some small profit and, back in the 60s and 70s. And actually, what was going on in Sälen and Trysil in these years was the new path creation. New industrial path was established. It included ski lifts. It included knowledge and technology to prepare ski tracks. It included cabins and other types of lodging, cafeterias and ski rental. All of these were small inventions, which were, of course, there were something going on in the Alps. The tourism sector in the Alps was before in the Scandinavia, and there were other places in Scandinavia which also developed their skiing tourism in these years. But Trysil and Sälen, they were quite early starters anyway. And these places developed on each side of the border, isolated by the national border between Sweden and Norway until early 2000s, when people across the border started to talk, started to exchange IDs, and started to launch ideas to cooperate, to increase the market, to attract more tourists to this combined cross-border region instead of competing about the same tourists. And even the idea of establishing an international airport in the region was launched in the early 2000s. And also Interreg, Sweden-Norway, was quite active in this region, and they could provide financing of some projects for cross-border cooperation. It started with energy efficiency in ski destinations, and then businesses learned that this sort of cross-border cooperation could actually help them. It could actually help them in improving the bottom line. And the politicians and business leader together initiated what is called the Sæther cooperation model, based on the name of the municipalities in this region. And they got funding from Interreg in Scandinavia to further develop their ideas together. And also the idea of the airport materialized, and the airport opened in the December 2019. With retrospect, we understand today that to open a new airport in December 2019 was not the perfect time of opening a new airport, because 3 months after the COVID pandemic struck, meant that lots of activities had to close down in Scandinavia. But planning for the opening of this airport created a lot of activity, and because it was realized by politicians and business leaders that the whole region had to upgrade to be able to provide high quality tourism tourism activities for international tourists. And Interreg was used to increase the skills and competences, and especially among small firms. But also this airport attracted private investors to the region on both sides of the border. They invested in new hotels and apartments in both Sälen and Trysil. Also, summer tourism is is very important for regions based on winter tourism, because summer tourism, that if you succeed in summer tourism, it means that you can provide year-round jobs for your workers. And this is also very important to attract new inhabitants that start families and buy homes in such regions. So it was necessary for both municipalities and businesses to invest in mountain biking, because mountain biking is a new popular trend among tourists across the north of Europe. What we see is that the cross-border cooperation has had some important regional effects. It has stimulated the regional economy. It has, in particular, stimulated the construction industry and a wide range of services, which is now in demand, of course, in particular in the high season, during winter, but also in summer. So I think these politicians and business leaders, they were able to realize their visions and increase local economic growth. And what about Interreg then? The role of Interreg is maybe not the money itself, but that it's an institutional structure for having people talk together and start working together across a national border, which has been quite important in this case, I think. And then we can see that during the last years, population decline has stopped. And even in some municipalities, a small increase since 2015. And to me, population change is a key indicator of regional development. And I have some numbers here. We can see that, the latest numbers in Malung-Sälen, they have managed to increase their population even with 2 years of COVID-19. And on the Norwegian side, it's at least quite stable. So overall, the population change has stabilized the last 5 years. And that is, to me, that's an important achievement. And some reflections. It is possible to develop a new industrial path in a small rural region with 25,000 people far away from major big cities. And the strategy of this work with retrospect can be, I think, is construction of regional advantage, which is the strategy that has been followed by businesses and politicians. And we have seen both necessity-motivated entrepreneurship and we have seen opportunity-motivated entrepreneurship. We have seen during the last 10, 20 years, we have seen external investors coming in and investing capital in hotels and cabins. But it's also a lot of motivated local people working very hard to improve the quality of the destination. But of course, since tourism has been so successful in this region, this region has become very much dependent on one business sector. And during COVID-19, that sector had to close down, not to the same amount on both sides of the border, but especially on the Norwegian side of the border, it was a really hard close down of tourism in March 2020, and unemployment rose really more than 20% in a few weeks. So it is a long-term challenge to develop a more diversified regional economy in Trysil and Sälen. And of course, local actors are very much aware of this, but yeah. So I just then thank you. Thank you for being able to tell you this fascinating story. Thank you.